Hi, Sagittarius. This is going to be the you versus them spread for the week of December 17th. So this is a love reading, Sagittarius. But keep in mind that love can pertain not just to your partner, but it could be an ex, friend, family member, coworker, you name it. So whoever it resonates with is who it's for. And because it's a general reading, it can go vice versa. So please do keep that in mind. So I'm going to pull cards, Sagittarius, for what your hopes, fears, and next steps are. And then I'm going to pull cards on the person external to you, what their hopes, fears, and next steps are, okay? Just FYI, you can check out my social media accounts by clicking on the links below and get some other neat information and videos that you can't get here on YouTube. So make sure you follow those pages as well. And if you haven't subscribed, please do. I go live every weekend. And if you subscribe, you'll get a notification. If you join me in the chat, I do pick people randomly to do readings on during those. So make sure you don't miss out. All right. So, enough about me. Let's talk about you, Sagittarius. All right. Sagittarius, overall energy for the week of December 17th. All right, definitely walking away from some past hurt, you know. Some of you are disappointed in someone. Also, you know, if love is being, some of you walked away from a love offer, actually. Somebody might have tried to give you, like, ask you out or just try and show affection even. And Sagittarius, you might have kind of turned your back on that this week because there might have been some hurt feelings here, okay? Of course, this can go vice versa. It could be the opposite. They did this to you, but... So the person external to you and their energy, they have Judgment and the Queen of Pentacles. It's very interesting. So I feel like the person external to you, Sagittarius, is trying to focus more on career, money, stability, trying to make decisions around that. If you're a female Sagittarius, their focus might be like on the mothering side. This person might have like a motherly energy about them, or they view you this way, Sagittarius. And there's some sort of decision here that's in their energy that needs to be made or like communicated regarding either the family or something to do with money. So that's interesting. How you view them, Sagittarius. Sagittarius, I feel like you think this person is delaying something. Delaying a decision, maybe. And that's kind of putting the relationship in like a stagnant period here. But I do see that you feel like this person has, you know, you see potential in this person. You know that they're a hard worker. I'm getting a lot of work vibes here. This is interesting. You see them as somebody who tries to, like I said, a hard worker, But I feel like in the work sector, there's some sort of news or decision that needs to be made here, and things are kind of on pause there. There might be a new opportunity for this person in the work environment that they're considering. All right. But they're kind of delaying either telling you about it or there's a delay in that decision. So that's very specific. That's not going to be for everybody, but I feel like Sagittarius, you also view this person as, yeah, not communicating about. There's something going on here that they're not communicating with you about. And like, what's weird is you have an awareness about it because this isn't how you view them. So you know that they aren't telling you everything. And that could be why you, like I said earlier, in your overall energy, that you kind of turn your walk away from the situation. Some of you feel like this person distracts themselves with work. And that hurts you, actually. It hurts your feelings. So let's see. Let's get some more cards out so we can get more specific here. How does the person view Sagittarius? How does the person view Sagittarius? Well, I feel like this person, Sagittarius, has a deep affection and love for you because they have the Ace of Cups and how they view you, and that's like the best card. So I do feel like this person cares a lot about you. You know? And again, I've got another card out regarding money. So there's something to do with finances here. A lot of you may have shared finances with this person either in the past or currently. Doesn't have to be all of you, but. And then the King of Wands. So I'm picking up another scenario, but I'm going to finish this one first. So yeah, Sagittarius. Like I said earlier, and how this person views you, particularly if you're a woman, but it could be male or female. They feel like you might be the boss of the relationship, actually, or a little bossy at times. That they view you as intelligent. They have a lot of emotion for you, Sagittarius, a lot. All right. This person does feel like that you hold back. So remember earlier I said that you were kind of like turning your back. Well, this talks about withholding. So they're aware that you're withholding too. So you might be withholding your emotions or holding on tightly to your feelings. Some of you, this has to deal with finances, and you might be really saving up your money right now. Or withholding some money from this person, or they think you are. That'll be a few of you. But also, Sagittarius, they view you in almost an alpha status. So, male or female, I think this person feels like you run the, you have the majority of the control in the relationship, okay? They also view you as somewhat being cold and detached at times, particularly if you're hurt, that you could be, a little bit temperamental, angry. So watch your words when you get angry, Sagittarius. So let's see your next steps. Next steps. Three of Swords in the reverse. Yeah. Like I said earlier, This person has hurt you. It's not recent. I just feel like it resurfaces a lot for you, Sagittarius. You might go, like I said, through periods of the relationship where, like, old stuff comes back up even, you know? Like, old memories. The Eight of Cups also talks about something that happened in the past. You've got the Three of Swords in the reverse. Something that happened in the past. So, towards the end of the week, I do feel like, you know, you're trying to walk away from that energy, actually. So, if you were in maybe a lower vibration or in a energy of where you were going through, like, a depression or just not feeling the best about yourself, I feel like you're trying to come out of that towards the end of the week, but something dredges it back up. Something has brought that back up. So, trying to release that. And I do feel like, Sagittarius, for a lot of you, you're going to have some type of new spark in either the relationship or external to the relationship by the end of the week. Because I see you feeling like you're getting back into the driver's seat, like you're getting back into control over the situation or the relationship. And then you end on the Four of Wands in reverse. So you've got Three of Swords, Ace of Wands, Emperor, Four of Wands. So just as soon as you feel like you get back under control, you might have another little shakeup. Well, darn. Person external to you, what are their next steps? So they've got, okay, for some of you, there is definite, there's something going on with money here, okay? I've got a couple different scenarios, so I'm going to finish this one and then I'm going to go into another one. And the person external to you's next steps, they want to work on this. You know, they want to work on this partnership. Like I said, they have a lot of love for you. I also do see them still kind of drowning in work. I think they're worried about finances or trying to build up finances or save finances or something to do with that. And they might be even juggling some of their money or hoarding it, I want to say. But I do feel like, you know, this person wants more stability within the emotional arena of the relationship. But I feel like, Sagittarius, the person external to you might be, like I said earlier, not fully communicating or not opening up or whatever. And the reason is that there's something going on at work that's taking their attention away from the relationship. I feel like that is an extremely heavy focus for this person. Okay. And yeah. Because there's something about waiting for communication at work. Or they might have received it, but they're waiting for the right time to talk to you about it. All right. So that was one scenario. If that resonated, cool. If not, here's the second one. I feel like there's a couple different groups of you that I'm connecting with. For some of you, Sagittarius, you walked away from a relationship where the person that you were with was not a good communicator. You might have blocked them. They might have blocked you. They might have been, like, purposely putting delays in the relationship, purposely not moving things forward, you know, like stuck in a contemplation mode and not making any actions. And this caused you to walk away from the relationship because you got tired of either waiting on them or you felt like there was something they're not telling you. I do feel like this person has definitely hurt you. And, you know, maybe every time you try to have a new beginning, they might come back around and that kind of makes you unstable again. Because they may come back around and try to regain control or try to promise action, you know. But then it results in making you unstable again, all right? And I feel like the person external to you, they have a lot of love for you. But for a small portion of you, this person also has another person that they're having a difficult time letting go of. And this could be an ex that they still have around, but maybe they had shared finances with that person. And so that person still needs to be in their life. And somehow that affects your relationship with them because you feel like they're always in a state of like juggling both, you know, trying to have give and take with both. And that could be where the money thing is coming in, particularly if they owe this person alimony or child support, things like that. That's very specific. And I feel like that's, you know, the person gets distracted by that. But yet they still have a lot of deep emotion for you. So that was scenario two. Scenario three is only going to be for a few of you. Not everybody's in a third party. Some of you, the person, Sagittarius, you or the person you're dealing with is with somebody else, has another partner. But they're holding on tightly to you because they feel like they're in love with you. But you don't see potential, you see potential in the relationship, but you know it's not going anywhere. So you may try to have a new beginning elsewhere, but yet not gaining stability just yet. And I feel like the person external to you that's juggling, they may be waiting on communication from you later on this week. And they may even be like, checking up on you. Like if you have social media, they may be checking it to see like what you're up to. So, three scenarios. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. All right. No matter what scenario you're in, what is the overall hope and fear for Sagittarius for this week? Overall hope and fear for Sagittarius. Yeah. Like I said, Sagittarius, you want to feel abundant. You want to feel in control. Some of you want to be single, period. Even regardless of what scenario you're in. For those of you that don't want to be single, I just see a high focus on building your own self-awareness. All right. And working on bettering yourself. That's the hope. And person external to you, hope and fear. Star card. Like I said, regardless of what scenario you are in, regardless, I feel like this person sees a lot of hope in the relationship. They want to heal it. Sagittarius, because like I said, they are deeply in love with you. And so I feel like for them, you know, some of them are trying to get their money together because they feel like they need to come correct, you know, like on top of their game for you. So let's see what the overall message is. For Sagittarius. Raw message. Yeah, get more information. That's what I just said. Because I feel like you might be thinking this person is being this way towards you for another reason than what it really is. And so make sure you have all the facts before you, you know, make any action here. And the other card that flew out that way was don't stop. Don't stop working on yourself, Sagittarius. Don't stop following your own passions. Don't, if this person is in a stagnant phase, don't join them there. You know what I'm saying? Keep your fire lit. You're a fire sign. You need action in your life. You need it to feel like a Sagittarius. Sagittarius loves action. So, that's your reading. Let me tell you the zodiac signs I see. Don't get caught up on them because it is a general reading. But I'll tell you anyways. I've got definite earth. I have many, many earth pentacles here. So Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus. Heavy on that. I do also see Aquarius. Could be Libra or Gemini as well. I do have another fire sign here. You might be dealing with another Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. And I have Aries here. Possibly a water sign, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. That's basically all the signs, guys. But I do hope that resonated. If it did, please do like, share, and subscribe. And I will see you next week. Namaste. Bye.